Hi everyone, welcome y'all. In the today's video, we're going to see the folder structure of Cypress project. So if I look at here, this is our project which we have created. So as soon as you created your Cypress project in Visual Studio Code Editor, we will by default get some folders, like you can see here, downloads, E2e, fixtures, and so on. Now let us try to understand what is these folders and each folder, like what we can store in each and every folder in the project. So this folder structure a little bit different in Cypress 10 version, especially if you go with the previous versions, you can see some different type of folders called plugins, index, and so on. And this particular folder structure newly changed from Cypress 10 onwards. Okay, so let us look at each and every folder and we'll see what kind of files we can store in those folder structure. So let me share a small picture here. So if I just look at this, so Cypress is main folder, so in which all folder structure will be created. And the first one is downloads. You can see here, this is the downloads. So in this, we can store all downloaded files. So sometimes when you write your automation code and which is downloaded some files, right? And those files we can store inside the download folder. So this folder contains the downloaded files through our automation. Now the next folder is E2e folder. So this is a main folder where we will write all your specification files, or we can say test case files, like the extension of the file should be cy.js. So all those files we will store in the E2e. So if you look at here, E2e, we already created some tests here and all the files are having cy.js extension. This is a E2e folder. So where we can store all our specification files or test cases. Now the next one is fixtures. This is another important folder where we can maintain the static test data. So sometimes we need data to run our test cases, or we need to use some data while running our test cases. So the data we can mention in the fixtures. So fixtures folder contains a static data. So for example, if I expand this folder, they have given a sample file like example.json. And you can just look at here, this data is available in the JSON format, like a name, email, and a body. So like this, we can add some static data in this particular file, and this data we can use in our test cases later. So this is a fixtures, and which contains a static test data. So we can create any number of files in the JSON format. Now, the next one is screenshot folder. So screenshot folder contains a captured screenshot through your automation. So sometimes when you run your test cases, screens we can capture. So those screenshots we can store in the screenshot. This is a default folder. Now the next one is a support folder. So this support basically contains a reusable scripts. So again, there are two kinds of scripts we can store. One is commands.js and e2e.js. There are two files are provided inside the support. Commands.js, e2e.js. In the commands.js, we can store or we can create custom commands. So by default, Cypress will provide you some commands and we can override those commands. We can create our own commands. They are called custom commands. Or suppose there are some existing commands. If you want to override those commands, we can still override. So those custom commands we can include in the commands.js. So if you look at here, if I just go to the support commands.js, so basically they have just given a simple commands. So far, there are no commands available. So if you just look at here, this is a custom command, cypress.commands.add, and this is a command name, and this is implementation of the particular command. So this is a user-defined command. We can create our own commands, or we can also override existing commands. So for example, visit is a command which is already there in Cypress. So we can access this command by using cy.visit. Suppose if you want to override the functionality of this particular command, we can enable this. This is a statement, cypress.commands.override. We can specify which command we want to override, specify that command, and change the implementation of that command. So commands.js is especially used for creating our own custom commands, Cypress commands, or we can override existing Cypress command. For that, we can use commands.js file. Now there is one more file called e2e.js, and this particular file contains some commands, or we can say some tests, that code which will load before starting your spec files. So normally when you run your tests here into E2e folder, so before executing these spec files, if you want to execute some steps as a prerequisite, right? So those scripts we can keep inside the E2e.js. So for example, so here I mentioned some commands. Let's say require cypress.xpath, require ./commands, import ./commands. So these statements will automatically execute before executing your test files. So for example, here I specify required cypress-xpath. This is basically a plugin. So we should include this here to use xpath. So we already install xpath plugin so that we can use xpath locator. But once you install xpath plugin, that is not enough. We have to specify this command. We need to specify this require inside e2e.js so that this will automatically load at the time of executing your test. That is called e2e.js. So which is basically contains some statements or some piece of code which will load automatically before starting your test. And the next one is videos folder. So this particular folder contains recorded files in the MP4 format. So when you run your test cases, if you capture any recorded video, that will store in the videos folder. Now the next one is node_modules. And this node_module contains all Cypress related modules. So by using NPM, we have installed Cypress initially, right? So once you install Cypress by using NPM modules, automatically all modules will be there in the node_modules. The next one is Cypress config.js. And this is another important Cypress configuration file. And this particular file contains a Cypress configuration. So for example, if I just go to cypress.config.js, so this is a default code they have basically given. So in this, if you want to add any specific Cypress related configuration, you can just add it here. So currently there's no configuration is added. And suppose if I just look at the first line, define config. So the define config equal to require Cypress. That means what? This is automatically added to the define config. So this define config implementation is here. So here we say require Cypress. This is Cypress configuration. If I don't specify this, we can't access the Cypress commands. So we need to add this entry to access all Cypress related commands. This is a configuration file. And same thing we have done here also in the commands.js. If I just look at here. So here we can create our own custom commands or we can override existing commands. If I just go to e2e.js, here also we have done the same thing. Require cypress.xpath. But here we just specify the statement. But this is not part of your Cypress configuration. So if you want to make this as part of Cypress configuration, the same thing, require cypress-xpath, we can specify inside configuration just like this. We can create another variable and we can add that into that particular variable. So this is another file where we can specify the Cypress configuration. And there is one more file called package.json. And basically this file contains the dependencies, like whatever additional plugins which we have installed on Cypress will be added into this particular file, like Cypress XPath plugin, which we have added dev dependency. So which is added now, Cypress is also added. So that is also part of this dependency. So Cypress is also there. So this is the XPath. And here you can see this is our project name. And so there are scripts and other dependencies. And here you can see Cypress version. So this is one dependency and the Cypress is another dependency. So these two dependencies are currently maintained. In future, if you add any other dependencies, will be part of package.json. So these are the different folders currently which we have in Cypress 10 onwards. So E2e, which is for storing tests, download is for downloading files, and fixtures, where we can maintain the static test data. Screenshot folder, we can keep all the screenshot in that folder. And support is basically having reusable script, like commands, custom commands, we can create or overwrite existing commands. UTE folder also having some commands which we can automatically load before starting the test. And videos contains the videos for video files. And the node modules contain the Cypress related modules. And Cypress config.js contains the Cypress configuration files. And the another one is package JSON, which contains all the dependencies for Cypress. So these are the different folders and files which we have in the Cypress project. Now, so whenever you are writing some script, let's say if I take some example here, we're accessing all Cypress command, right? cy.vz, cy.title, like this. So if you want to get auto suggestion, so there is one more feature in Cypress. If you want to get automatically these command, by default, you won't get. Okay, so if you want to get this auto suggestion, which is also called as intelligence auto suggestion, or we can say intelligent automated suggestions. So if you want to get these options, Cypress commands, what we can do is we need to go to here, something called commands. Okay, and in the commands, we can just enable these two. So we need to write /reference types equal to Cypress. So this is for Cypress and this is for XPath. Okay, so /s is required. This is not a comment actually. Okay, reference types equal to Cypress. This is for accessing Cypress command and this is for accessing XPath methods in the Cypress. Reference types equal to Cypress.XPath. So if you specify these commands inside the command.js, so automatically when you're writing your automation script, you will get all the Cypress commands and XPath related commands automatically you will get. And this is the one place we can specify there. Suppose if you don't want to specify this, then if you still want to get auto suggestion, you need to add these two statements in every script. So before starting the describer block, here we need to add those two statements just like this. Go to every script and before that we need to add. Again, to add this in every script, again, duplication, right? So instead of writing the same statement in every test script file, instead of doing that, we can make that part of commands.js automatically. So when you specify that reference inside the commands.js, automatically you will get a auto suggestions when you're accessing the Cypress commands. So to access Cypress commands, this only one reference is enough. Or if you want to use XPath, right? If you already install XPath plugin, if you want to access like cy.xpath something, let's say cy.xpath. So you can see here, by default, you will not get, you can see cy.xpath. So I'm getting XPath here, but by default, you won't get this XPath, even though you have installed plugin. So you need to add that reference. Okay, so this reference you can add in the spec file, or if you don't want to repeat this in every spec file, just go to commands.js and here you can add the reference. Okay, so these commands will automatically apply for every test before starting every test spec file. So these two commands are applicable. Okay, so this is all about folder structure. That's the reason we say reusable scripts. Reusable scripts in the sense what? Whatever we specify in the commands.js, and these commands will automatically applicable for every test script. Okay, so this is one of the important feature in Cypress. Intelligence auto suggestions. We can also call as intelligence automated suggestions. If you want to get, we need to add these two references under commands.js. So then onwards, we can access all the Cypress command. And here, you don't need to specify. This is optional. Okay. So this is all about folder structure and intelligence auto suggestion feature. In the next video, we will discuss a few more things. Thanks for watching.